Welcome to Cinemeric Live, application technology made easy. The aim of this series of short videos is to present specific topics on the practical use of Cinemeric. Today, we'll continue with the third part of our special video series on flexible CNC programming. As always, I'd like to point out that the individual parts of this video series build on each other and should therefore be viewed chronologically. In the two previous videos, I explained what flexible CNC programming can be used for and what user variables are all about. Today, we'll be dealing with a very extensive topic, namely the mathematical operations in the Cinemeric CNC language. I'd like to demonstrate this with a few concrete examples. We'll do without the agenda today. First of all, my first tip. To program the mathematical functions undisturbed in your office, simply use a digital twin of the CNC. Another good reason for doing this is because the sometimes difficult calculations in the machining programs can be tested on the PC before they're used on the real machine. This brings reliability. For this purpose, I myself use Run My Virtual Machine, the virtual Cinemeric One. Now, let's start with something simple, namely the basic arithmetic operations. These are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. I'll explain what integer number division, div, and modulo division, mod, are useful for right after the arithmetic rules. So, let's look at the arithmetic rules first. The arithmetic rules define the priorities in the arithmetic operations. As is usual in mathematics, multiplication and division, before addition and subtraction, also applies to Cinemeric, and otherwise quite simply from left to right. If this system has to be overridden, we'll just use parentheses, as is common in mathematics. By placing parentheses, the original precedence rule can be overridden. Let's move on to the mod and div operations. I mention them explicitly because I need them frequently when working on machining cycles. When it comes to managing infeeds during milling or drilling, these operations are essential. For example, if we want to mill a pocket with multiple infeeds, we should know in advance how many complete infeeds there are and what the remainder is. So, first, I define one floating point variable for the depth and one for the desired infeed. Then, another variable for the number of complete infeeds and one for the value of the incomplete infeed, that is, for the remainder. Now, we assign values to the variables, for example, 35 mm for the pocket depth and 10 mm for the infeed. The integer division then yields the number of complete infeeds, in our case, 3. And with the modulo division, you get the remainder, which is the value of the incomplete infeed. In our case, that's 5 mm. On the subject of machining cycles, a few more useful arithmetic functions fit the bill. For example, functions for round to an integer, round up, and for forming the integer component. The round-up function can be demonstrated well on our pocket. Let's remember, the pocket is to be milled with multiple infeeds. Here it might happen that such a minimal remainder remains during machining that the tool barely cuts a chip and only presses. For this reason, the original number of infeeds should be rounded up to a number with a constant cutting depth. To do this, we again define one variable for the pocket depth, one for the desired infeed, and another for the calculated number of infeeds with a constant cutting depth. As in our previous example, we assign values to the variables again, 35 mm as the pocket depth and 10 mm for the desired infeed. The roundup function is now used to increase the fractional number of infeeds to the next higher, even value. In our case, from 3.5 to 4. Finally, the adjusted infeed needs to be calculated. In our case, this would be 8.75 instead of the original 10 mm. This completes the settings. Cinemeric offers many other important arithmetic functions, such as trigonometric functions, square root, second power, absolute value, natural logarithm, and exponential function. By the way, in the context of control structures, we'll take a closer look at the sine function in the next video, where we'll also be discussing logic operators for linking truth values. As we've seen today, the Cinemeric CNC syntax for mathematical operations is structured exactly as we remember it from our math lessons at school. Complex mathematical calculations can be entered directly into the CNC in the usual way. The readable names of the user variables also contribute considerably to making mathematics with the Cinemeric CNC programming language transparent and easy to understand. So much for today's topic, mathematical operations for flexible CNC programming. If you don't want to miss any further episodes, simply subscribe to the CNC for You newsletter. It contains all the latest news and interesting facts about the application of Cinemeric. So, if you haven't already done so, just enter CNC for You in the search engine, register, and you're all set up. This way, you'll always stay up to date. That's all for today. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.